Hello children, happy morning, welcome back to English class. Today I am going to teach you an interesting poem. The poem is Topsy-Turvy Land. The poem was written by H.E. Wilkinson. It was a unique poem, it was an imaginary poem. In this poem, we are going to see some strange things which we cannot really see it. Students, do you want to see Topsy-Turvy Land? Come on, let us start. Look at this image, my dear students. Children, let me ask you some questions. Have you ever thrown your school bag on your bed? Have you ever left your shoes and socks here and there? Have you ever played with your ball in your room? Does your room sometimes look like this? So think for some time and recall. If you did, then what did your mother or father told you? Isn't this strange, students? Now let us start the poem. The poem name is Topsy-Turvy Land. It's really a vivid and imaginary land, beautifully described by the poet H.E. Wilkinson. Have you ever heard this poem before? Let's begin with the warm-up exercise. Here we have questions. Think of an imaginary place, city or town, which is very different from one in which we live now. Describe the things that would be different in this place. Here you can see two pictures. One is, you know this story, the crocodile and the monkey. It's just a story, a fairy tale. We cannot see really like that one. Yes or no, students? The second picture is, can you guess? It's a movie image from Avatar, very famous English movie directed by James Cameron. In this movie, we can see a complete different world itself. People lived under a big tree. They flew over a bird called Ikran. You can see here people on the bird. The people are also very taller than like us. Isn't this strange, students? Can you imagine like this world really around us? Think of it. So my students, we can see such many imaginary things where we can see in an imaginary land. Now I am going to read the poem and I will be explaining. Listen carefully. Let us start with the first stanza. The people walk upon their heads. The sea is made of sand. The children go to school by night in Topsy-Turvy Land. So my dear students, in the first stanza, we are talking about particular land or specific place where people walk upon their heads. Isn't this strange, students? Have you seen people like that in your life? It's an amazing thing happened here in this place because usually we walk upon with our feet. Right here in this place, it is quite different. People walk upon their heads. You can see the picture here. Children are here upon their heads. And another thing, the sea is made of sand. Usually sea is made of water, but here it is different. Usually children go to school in the morning, but in this poem, we see children go to school at night. So all these things possible only in Topsy-Turvy Land. It is an imaginary land. Let's move to next stanza. The front door step is at the back. You are walking when you stand. You wear your hat upon your feet in Topsy-Turvy Land. In this second stanza, we are talking about front door. Normally we enter a house with front side, but here it's completely different. The front door steps are at the back. Isn't this strange, students? People are walking when you stand. It's an amazing thing. Just imagine. See, you are walking when you are standing. Is it possible really, my dear students? Not at all. It's a different, strange thing we see here. We usually wear a hat upon our head, but here on feet, such a different thing we can see only in Topsy-Turvy Land. Move to the next stanza. And buses on the sea you will meet while pleasure boats are planned To travel up and down the streets of topsy-turvy land, we see buses travel on the roads, isn't it, students? And boats on the water. But in this poem, it is different thing. It's strange thing. It's a very, very funny. Pleasure boats means for relaxation. Boats travel, you know, up and down on the streets. You can see here bus traveling on the water. And you can see children traveling on boat on the streets. You know, something strange we can see only in topsy-turvy land. Such things we cannot see really in our life. Move to the last stanza. You pay for what you never get. I think it must be grand. For when you go, you are coming back in topsy-turvy land. My students, when you go to shop, okay, you give money to buy something from the shopkeeper, and he will not give money or anything. What you will do at the time? Okay, so it is something opposite thing. So when you go forward, you feel you are coming back. So I think it must be grand. Grand means wonderful. Okay, so this is something different. So when we go to shop, we give money and the shopkeeper gives something. So we feel happy. If he doesn't give, no, we get angry, we cry. Okay, but it is something strange thing, my dear students, happening in this poem. Whatever you see in this poem, all are done differently. Strange things, which we can't see really. It is just an imaginary land described by the poet Wilkinson. This poem is really interesting. This is a vivid poem. It has different imaginations. We feel that we are living in a fairy tale, such kind of imaginations. So actually, this kind of imaginary land doesn't exist. This will never happen in our life. This kind of land doesn't exist in this world. So my students, I hope you enjoyed this poem. We can see all different things happening in this poem, which we cannot see in our real life. Hope that I am clear to you. Thank you, students.